Right, friends, what is this concept? I'll once again go through. Everybody can go through this with me. This is a problem where we are asked to do reconciliation. I am doing everything together. Reconciliation is done in a traditional method. That is what I explained yesterday. In a traditional method, profit as per original budget, take all the variances computed, plus or minus, and then you will arrive at the actual profit, then tally it with the actual profit statement. So there our focus is on focusing on the calculations of the variances traditionally. Now in the final level, in the advanced level, you are asked the question, why don't you apply marginal costing for standard costing? Alright, marginal costing application means you ignore the fixed cost, because marginal costing is driven by contribution. Marginal costing, sales minus marginal cost, is contribution. That is how the CVP analysis moves, and fixed cost is considered as a sunk cost, written off to the contribution. When you don't consider fixed cost, please listen very carefully, then the volume variance will not come into the picture. Remember that point. Whenever marginal costing technique is applied in standard costing, fixed cost will not come into the picture. When fixed cost doesn't come into the picture, volume variance will not be there. Computation is not required. Fine. I started with traditional thinking. So here they say in the entire problem, the price variance is not there, sales price variance not there, material price not there, labor rate variance not there, labor rate not. Therefore, whatever the variances, cost variances is equal to usage variances. That is to be clear. So I have given you notes. Now I am taking further. You have produced 1800. So standard cost is for actual production. So standard cost is 1800 into 40, 72,000. You should have spent 72,000, but what you have spent is 80,000. Therefore, material cost variance is 8,000 adverse. Since there is no price variance, then the cost variance becomes usage variance. Now 8,000 adverse in terms of quantity, this is in terms of rupees, divided by standard rate. 8,000 divided by 4, that is equal to 2,000 kgs. Then we are applying relevant cost. What is the concept of relevant cost here? Is you are introducing the concept of opportunity cost. When you say 2,000 kgs wasted by the production manager, how to debit that fellow's performance? Is it at standard rate agreed, 2,000 into 4, 28,000? No. When materials are scarce, we could have used these materials to generate contribution, and that is lost. Therefore, it's called as the opportunity cost. So, what is that opportunity cost lost? Then we went further to calculate. I again calculated, but you could have done it in working note 1, contribution. You do it in step by step. Every step will carry marks. So contribution is 80 rupees and 1 unit, 10 kgs, 8 rupees per kg. So that means the actual loss is not just 4 rupees plus 8 rupees, 12 rupees, that is 24,000 is lost because of the production manager wastage. That is the concept, because standard costing is based on fixing the accountability. Collateral damages will be there. You understand, whenever you are testing something, you 360 approach they call, that means overview you have to take. You understand? So that part is clear. Now friends, with this knowledge that I have given you, can you go with labor like that? Next point is, you have to try and tell me, because you are writing exam. Therefore, labor, I request you to try exactly as I explained. Okay, thereafter I will come back. Okay, scarce raw material, scarce labor, and then no scarce inputs. Three situations we are going to reconcile and explain you how to fix the accountability on production manager, personnel manager, sales manager, and then from the examination point of view, how you can solve it. Within 2 minutes you should solve. I'll tell you how, and you should know your answer is right. Thank you. Are you all with me? Any doubts, please? I would like to explain. Are you clear? Aishwarya, you now try. Everybody should try and tell me. I can do it. No, that is not a big deal, but I would like to see whether you are able to understand and tell me the answer. Thank you. Okay, now the second situation we have got is labor is the key factor. When labor is the key factor, how do you go about it? Simply like material only. We are only interested variable cost. Material, labor, variable overheads behave in the same fashion. So, when you are going to labor, same manner, 1800 into 64, 115,200. I am speaking slowly. If you are not able to hear, you tell me. Loud speaking, throat is paining. 1800 into 64, 115,200. Actual cost is 14,800 hours into. So, labor cost variance is 3,200 hours adverse. Now, there is no rate variance. Therefore, labor cost variance is equal to labor efficiency variance, that is equal to 3200 adverse. So rupees, that is rupees 3200, you should take it there. This is rupees. So in terms of hours, divide by standard rate, 3200 by 8400 hours wasted. So when labor is the key factor, then contribution lost because of 400 hours we have to take. So opportunity cost is 4000. In other words, 7200 is lost. So we have tested our traditional method, and then we are gone to scarce resources, labor and material. Now there are no scarce resources. Suppose material is free, labor scarce means what? I need 100 kgs. I have got 120 kgs. There is no scarcity. I need 100 kgs. But I have only 80 kgs, then there is scarcity. That is called key factor. Key factor is one which limits the production. It is key factor. Understand, today nobody is, many people are dying because of no oxygen. So actually oxygen is freely available, but because of some reasons, mismanagement, and also because of the disease, which is affecting you, and that is scarce. After few days it will become normal. Actually don't know why so many people are dying, friends. I am not able to understand, because many of my friends who got, they are cured, and so many dead bodies they are showing, you know, disturbing, and everybody, old people above 80 is gone, tup, they are dying. And what is the reason? I am not able to understand, except saying you should be very, very careful. You should be very, very careful, friends. Precious life. We can do service to the nation. Now, friends, what is the last one is, we wanted to sell 2000, but we sold 1800. So 200 units we have not sold. And 200 units you don't sell, you should have lost the profit of 56 rupees. Understand, standard profit, that is 11,200. That's all. There no scarcity, that is, if labor and materials are freely available, then the question is, you sold 1800 units sold, as against budgeted 2000. So that means sales margin volume variance, that is how much, 1800 actuals AQ minus BQ 2000s into BM standard margin, budgeted margin is 6 rupees, how much, 60, 56, 11,200 rupees adverse. This is for the third column. You be ready? Now I will start explaining the problem. And the cost variances we have done, everything is with us, and traditional method also is there. Variable overhead efficiency variance we have to calculate, that's all, the last one. Now I'll go to calculate variable overhead. Rates are all same, so variable overhead is what, 48,000 is standard, that is for 22,000 units. This is 48,000 for 2000 units, that means 24 is the standard rate. For 1800, how much it should be? This is variable overhead cost variance. 48,000 is the standard cost for 2000 units. So standard rate is 24, and 1800 is actual production. So how much is that? 24 into 1800, 43,200. And what is the actuals? Actual cost is 44,400. This is standard cost. Actual cost is equal to 44,400. So that means the variance is 1200 adverse. There is no scarcity and all. Scarcity is only because it regards labor. So 1200 over. Fixed overhead cost variance nil. Anyway, we are not going to consider that. Now, at this juncture, we are trying to prepare the reconciliation statement. So far, are you okay with me? And if you want, I will explain once again. Just decide whether you want it or not. So, in the conventional method, the traditional first method we did, budgeted profit. We wanted to sell 2000 units and we should have got 56 rupees. So 1,12,000. And in a conventional method operating cost statement or reconciliation statement, you will have, here there are no price variances. Therefore, quantity variances only will be there. So sales margin volume variance. Institute material, they just said sales volume is wrong. So 200, because we sold only 1800. So 200 units less, therefore 200 into 56, 11,200. Then usage variance we calculated 8,000 adverse, efficiency 3,200 adverse, variable overhead efficiency 1200 adverse, fixed overhead volume variance 4,800. So actual profit 4,000. So dear friends, you have to understand one thing when you are doing the exam. We are conventional method, we are done. Now we are going to approach it. If material is scarce, how will you present it? Relevant cost and marginal cost. Marginal cost means fixed cost will not come. Remember that fixed cost column will be zero, nil, 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 all the three. So that is out, clear. Then the next question is, labor is scarce, we have done. Variable or the material is scarce, we have done, and no scarcity we have done. So three columns you have to present. But you remember only one thing, the profit 83,600 will be there. So even you do any mistake, you know how to tackle it. That is very, very important. So we are now going to the other method. This is raw material is scarce. Let us see. I am giving the clue for you. labor is the scarce. What happened this? Labor is scarce. How to push it this side, friends? Can you tell me? Yes, labor is scarce. How to do that? We will explain. This side is not coming. It should come, no? Yes, labor is not. How will you do? The rule is, I tell you, when you read, you don't understand. Is 83,600, 83,600, and this is also 83,600. Second thing, rule is this will not be there. And now you apply your mind, common sense. I will tell you how to handle this. Okay. All of you try it slowly. 5 minutes I'll give you, and thereafter we'll see. How to push it, that boy has explained something. Saran, click on the up arrow. He said, I want to push this side, no? Right. Let us wait. So we are explaining here, all of you listen to me, this point. When there are no constraints, because of sales manager, we can say, we lost 16,000 rupees adverse. We all agree, because the sales manager should have sold 2,000, but he ended up selling only 1,800. So 200 units he sold less. As a result, we have lost 200 into 80, 16,000. That is when there is no scarce. But when you are coming to the scarce resources, it is because of the labor force. That personal manager, production manager, 4,000 hours he wasted. 4,000 hours would have resulted in producing 50 units, and losing 50 units means 4,000 because of sales labor. Therefore, out of the 16,000, 4,000 he could not supply. That is why he couldn't sell. Therefore, in this case, you supplied and you couldn't sell. You are ready to supply, you couldn't sell. But here there is no quantity. That is the interpretation of the problem. Over. That's all, friends. You can read our institute material and get whatever you want to learn. And all the other things, this beautiful problem. Beautiful problem, first let's. But it's highly difficult to understand. So we made it very simple. And accordingly, we have put it across. Over. Thank you, friends. All the points are explained in detail, and why this 12,000, why 16,000. But ultimately, friends, whether you understand or not, you must understand 83,600 must come. Fixed overheads will not be there, and variable overhead will be same. So only alternative is this, the other thing. Sales also will be same. Budgeted profit will not change. What changes is that three. One is due to material scarcity, another is labor scarcity, third one is no scarcity. So that's all. Thank you. We are now moving out of this subject.